Welcome back. You're watching To The Point. MPs and ministers overstaying in their official residences even though they've lost an election and the right to continue is by no means unusual. It happens after every change of government. So when the government took strict steps to evict Ajit Singh from the 12th Tuglak Road residence he's lived in for over three decades, it was no great surprise. But yesterday his supporters staged violent protests demanding the Tuglak Road house be converted into a memorial for Ajit Singh's father, former Prime Minister Charan Singh. Not surprisingly, Ajit Singh has lent support to this demand. But is it justified? That's the big issue tonight. My guests are BJP spokesperson Sambit Patra, former professor of politics Pushpesh Pant, and from the Bharatiya Kisan Union, which supports Ajit Singh's Rashtriya Lok Dal Party, its general secretary Yudhvir Singh. Sadly, no one from the Congress Party, whose Haryana chief minister has written in support of Ajit Singh's demand, was prepared to join us. Yudhvir Singh, given that as far back as 2000, the government in Delhi declared that bungalows would no longer be converted into memorials for former political leaders, and given that this is something the Supreme Court endorsed specifically last year, and secondly, given that the people of Delhi clearly don't want their city to become a city of memorials, what justification do you have for demanding that 12 Tuglak Road should become a memorial for Chaudhary Charan Singh?
देखिए मैं आपकी जानकारी के लिए बता दूं कि कैबिनेट ने जो 2000 में जिस डिसीजन की कैबिनेट डिसीजन की आप बात करते हैं उसके बाद दो बंगले मेमोरियल के लिए इस दिल्ली में अलॉट हुए माननीय काशीराम जी को और माननीय जगजीवन राम जी को और जहां तक सुप्रीम कोर्ट की बात है सुप्रीम कोर्ट अगर देश को चलाता है तो फिर पार्लियामेंट की आवश्यकता क्या
है तो आप ये कह रहे हैं कि अगर कैबिनेट ने दो बार गलती कर दी तो तीसरे बार भी कर दीजिए
गलती की बात नहीं है किसान इस चौधरी चरण सिंह कोई आम इंसान नहीं थे किसान उनको एक देवता की तरह से पूजता और 12 तुगलक रोड किसानों का मंदिर चौधरी चरण सिंह को आप साधारण अगर राजनेता से तुलना करेंगे तो फिर मेरे पास उसका कोई जवाब
मैं नहीं कह रहा कि वो आम आदमी थे वो काफी मशहूर राजनेता थे लेकिन मैं आपको कुछ और कह रहा हूँ दिल्ली के लोग नहीं चाहते कि दिस सिटी शुड बिकम अ मॉसोलियम फॉर एंडलेस डेड प्राइम मिनिस्टर्स
दिल्ली में 35 लाख की आबादी तो हमारी है जिन किसानों की है और किसान नहीं चाहते 35 लाख तो हम रहते हैं दिल्ली में हमारी जमीन पे दिल्ली बसी है हमने सारा सैक्रिफाइस इस दिल्ली के लिए किया है जहाँ 12 तुगलक रोड है वो भी हमारे एक गांव
तो
की जमीन थी
इस 35 लाख की जोर पे हक जमा रहे हैं अपना इस 35 लाख की जोर पे आप हक
जोर नहीं जमा रहे हैं आप कह रहे हैं दिल्ली नहीं चाहती आप कह रहे हैं दिल्ली नहीं चाहती आप मतलब दिल्ली कुछ लोग नहीं चाहते होंगे जिनकी मानसिकता किसान
दिल्ली की पॉपुलेशन 35 लाख से काफी ज्यादा है भाई साहब
जी जो किसान की मानसिकता से मेल नहीं खाते हैं जो उन नहीं चाहते होंगे वो लेकिन हमारा जो कहना है कि हम किसान जो चरण सिंह में आस्था रखता है 100% किसान का ये आज से नहीं पिछले जब से चौ साहब गुजरे हैं उस कोठी में इसलिए जाता है कि एक मंदिर में अपने देवता को नमन करने जाता वो हमारा आस्था का केंद्र है चरण सिंह हमारे लिए उतने ही पूजनीय है जितने हमारे लिए कोई दूसरे
आपके लिए देवता हैं जैसे मूर्ति पे चढ़ावा डाला जाता है आप इस घर पे जाके भी चढ़ावा डालेंगे वो आपकी दिल की प्रसन्नता है मैं मानता हूं समित पात्रा लेट मी पुट इट लाइक दिस इफ दिल्ली कैन हैव मेमोरियल्स फॉर नेहरू शास्त्री इंदिरा गांधी काशीराम एंड जगजीवन राम एंड अकॉर्डिंग टू अजीत सिंह एंड आई एक्सेप्ट हिज वर्ड द लास्ट हैपेंड ओनली 6 months अगो देन व्हाई कांट देयर बी मेमोरियल फॉर चरण सिंह इफ यू आर गोइंग टू मेक एक्सेप्शंस फॉर अदर्स देन मेक एन एक्सेप्शन फॉर दिस मैन एज वेल
Karan, remember one thing. Whatever I'm going to speak, it is with due diligence to the departed soul, Mr. Charan Singh. We love him all, and with all due respect to the farmer community. First and foremost, the law of this land has to be respected. Lawmakers at least should be the least, should be the last person to break the law of this country. And this is appalling as to how Mr. Ajit Singh has been reacting. There is a standing order by the cabinet of this country. Well, yes, in 2000, when Mr. Atal Bihari Vajpayee was the prime minister, and if you would see the draft. Of the cabinet committee report you would realize two important points first and foremost the committee report suggests that if this is the rate of converting the Lutyens zone into memorials then the day is not far when all the government accommodations which is right now less than 200 buildings would in fact turn into memorials so they should best be put into the use that they're meant for and the use is to accommodate government officials and ministries secondly and most importantly they had said that this is also something which would which in the future would see to it that other people also start demanding such kind of memorial.
Okay.
So we stood by this 2000 cabinet note, but ironically Congress allocated the two, the UPA dispensation which was in power, they allocated two other memorials, Kansi Ram's memorial and Jagjivan Ram's memorial, which should not have been done. Even the Supreme Court stands by this whole verdict when listening to the Karnataka Transport Association's verdict in 2013 July. The Supreme Court passed 20-point order, and one of the point was that Delhi's Lutyens' Zone should not be converted into a memorial.
Absolutely.
Third important point, Kisan Ghat is a memorial after all. We all respect the farmer leader Charan Singh, and that's the result as to why we have a firm memorial, a very tall memorial, a very good place, that is Kisan Ghat.
Okay.
So we can all go and pay our obeyance whenever we want to pay obeyance to Charan Singh ji at Kisan Ghat. And remember, Mr. Charan, I mean Ajit Singh was a part of the UPA dispensation for quite long time. He could have easily raised
Mr.
this issue.
That's a pretty comprehensive answer. Pause for someone else to come in, but that's a very comprehensive answer, and I applaud you on your command of detail. Professor Pant, you heard Mr. Yudhvir Singh, and that claim for a memorial hinges upon the belief that Chaudhary Charan Singh was not an Aam Aadmi, although these days I will add, there's no crime in being an Aam Aadmi. It hinges on the fact that in fact he was special. I want to question that with you. Charan Singh was the only Prime Minister India's ever had who never faced Parliament even for 1 minute.
But Yudhvir Singh's argument would be very different. Whether he addressed the parliament, whether he addressed the nation from the ramparts, it doesn't matter. The Kisans respect him as a god. And if you are god, if Sachin Tendulkar is a god, Amitabh Bachchan is a god, Chaudhary Charan Singh is a god of Kisans, then there is no room for reason. That appeal is purely on the basis of faith and passion and emotion. And what Sambil is doing is a detailed rebuttal of that. My problem is, I find it extremely distressing that we are even discussing this. There is a rule of law. What disturbed me about Yudhvir Singh ji's statement was, agar Supreme Court ye kar raha hai, toh Parliament kya kar rahi hai? Which means that you are basically at one level subverting the rule of law. That's one. And my other argument is very simple. If it's not an argument, I have respected Chaudhary Charan Singh all my life as one of the leaders of integrity. My problem is different. My problem is, I thought we lived in a secular country. The Constitution gives me a freedom of faith and worshipping whatever I want, Kisan God or whatever. But I can't have it in public domain. That's number one. Number two, if a museum is to be made, is the museum to be given the shape of a house like a Teen Murti or Jagjivan Babu's house? And why should the memorial be entrusted in perpetuity to family members? Why can't there be a public trust? Why can't be a memorial in a form of a university, in form of scholarships or Kisans, in form of a massive, massive area, thousands of acres set apart to develop agriculture in this country?
All of which are perfectly valid questions and issues, but I'm going to take up the question I put to you and put it to Mr. Yudhvir Singh, because what I'm questioning, what I'm challenging is your claim that Chaudhary Charan Singh was a truly exceptional person. He was the only Indian Prime Minister who never faced Parliament even for 1 minute. He was never able to prove his majority, and he lasted as Prime Minister for less than 6 months. Does that record deserve a memorial?
आप उस बात को गलत ले रहे हैं. मैंने ये कहा ही नहीं कि एक प्रधानमंत्री की हैसियत से उनको बंगला मिलना चाहिए. मैंने ये कहा किसान नेता की हैसियत से उनको बंगला मिलना चाहिए. वो एक दिन भी पार्लियामेंट फेस किए. मैं आपकी बात बड़ी है, वो प्रधानमंत्री रहे नहीं, आप निकाल दो उनको बीच में से. वो चौधरी चरण सिंह थे, वो किसानों के मसीहा थे, किसानों करोड़ों किसानों के दिल में उस टाइम भी बसते थे और आज भी बसते हैं. किसानों के आदर्श हैं, किसान उनको देवता समान पूजते हैं.
मैं एक सवाल पूछूं आपसे,
अभी मेरे साथी कह रहे थे उनका किसान घाट उनका बना हुआ, क्या दूसरे जो लोग हैं जिनकी समाधियां वहां बनी हुई हैं उनकी स्मृति में भवन नहीं है?
आप कह रहे हैं कि किसान हैसियत पे आप उनके लिए मेमोरियल चाहते हैं, तो फिर बंगला क्यों मांग रहे हैं?
आप उनके
नाम में एक पार्क खोलिए, आप एक पार्क खोलिए सुंदर सुंदर गुलाब के फूलों के साथ उसको फैलाएं.
कर्म स्थली थी, वहां उन्होंने अंतिम सांस ली, वहां उन्होंने बैठ के इस देश के किसान को एक जो है ताकत दी, मजबूती दी, आवाज दी, वो उनका जो है इसलिए.
आपको पता लोग क्या कह रहे हैं? लोग कह रहे हैं कि असलियत ये है, आपको मेमोरियल नहीं चाहिए. लोग कह रहे हैं कि अजीत सिंह जी को और जयंत चौधरी साहब को दिल्ली के लच्चन जोन में एक बंगला चाहिए, और वो भी फ्री में चाहिए. ये बहाना
अगर,
है
अगर,
बंगला लेने के लिए और कुछ
नहीं. अगर वो मेमोरियल बनता है तो अजीत सिंह रह पाएंगे क्या? वो लोग ये नहीं जानते कि कानून क्या,
ये मेमोरियल की बात तब क्यों छेड़ी गई जब उनको कहा गया था कि घर छोड़ के जाइए? अगर छेड़नी थी तो 6 महीने पहले, 6 साल पहले जब वो मंत्री थे तब क्यों नहीं की?
ये किसी किसान से कौन लोग मानते हैं? वो लोग उस पर्सन ये है कि यहाँ दो तरह के लोगों का ये देश है। एक वो है जिनको गांव वालों में बदबू आती है, जिसके किसान नाम से बदबू आती है। जब चरण सिंह इस दिल्ली में आए थे तो मुझे पता है इस देश में ये कहा गया था कुल्लू का कोई नेता आगे, जाटों के नेता आगे, फलांक ने के ने, उन लोग को तो किसान नेता मानने को एक वर्ग तैयार नहीं था। वो तो कंट्रोवर्सी में जाए तो कोई भी बात चलती रहती है। लेकिन आज ये कह देना कोई इतना मतलब नहीं है कि चरण सिंह के लिए ही हमें बताया जाता कि पार्क में मेमोरी बना लो, कहीं किसान घाट पे चले जाओ। मतलब ये ड्यूअल पॉलिसी चलेगी इस देश में।
दिल्ली के घर के नीचे आप कुछ नहीं मांगने तो तैयार, यही आप लाएंगे। लक्ष्मण दिल्ली का 4 एकड़ का बंगला आपको मिले और कुछ नहीं चाहिए।
जिस घर में उन्होंने अंतिम सांस चौधरी साहब ने लिए वो उनका मंदिर है किसानों का, उससे कम कोई कुछ भी स्वीकार हमको नहीं है।
संबित पात्रा, लेट मी ब्रिंग यू इन। गिवन द वे इवेंट्स हैव डेवलप्ड इन द अजीत सिंह केस, given the fact that for 10 years when he was an MP and minister with his own government and power, it never occurred to him that this house should become a memorial for his father. In fact, it only occurred to him after he was given eviction notices, and that too after the water and electricity were cut off. Do you suspect that the real motive, even if it's not admitted, is that he somehow wants a house for himself and his son in Lakshman's Delhi, which otherwise he will not have?
No, it's something which is known to the whole of the nation today. I mean, it doesn't take a rocket science to deduce what you have right now said. It is already in the public today, and the public in fact is ridiculing Mr. Ajit Singh. And I'm pained with the fact that a great person as Mr. Charan Singh, a great farmer leader as Chaudhary Charan Singh, in fact his name has been belittled by this kind of blackmailing and ransom holding policy that his party and that Ajit Singh, his son, is using. I mean, a great man like Mr. Charan Singh probably would not have wanted that he being remembered by a mundane building. He lives in hearts of the farmers. A mundane building is after all a building. And all these years you were never demanding that building as a memorial, and suddenly when you were given an eviction letter as per the rule of the land, you remembered that they should be converted into a memorial.
Dost, 1 minute ruko, let me get in fact Yudhvir Singh ji to answer your question. Ye badi acha point bana rahe. If you want to remember Chaudhary Charan Singh, agar aap unke liye memorial banana chahte hain, apne dil mein banaye. एक पुराने घर में आप क्यों बनाना चाहते हैं? वो भी घर जिसकी लीकेज होती होगी, बारिशों में पानी टपकता होगा।
ये राम मंदिर क्यों बनाना चाहते हैं ये बता दो, ये घर में बना लें, इनका मुद्दा है, मेरा तो नहीं है। राम मंदिर क्यों बनाना चाहते हैं? दिल में ही बनाने से होता है, तो उस राम मंदिर की बात छोड़ दो जो 20 साल से देश को बेवकूफ बना रखा तुमने, और अपने दिल में राम को बसा लो, इस देश में शांति हो जाएगी, विवाद खत्म हो
जाएगा।
In a sophisticated manner, maybe, but necessary.
Except that he doesn't admit he incited them.
That is for the courts to decide if somebody files an FIR. I mean, you say if I unki bhavnaon ko samjhiye, unse sarkar negotiate kare. I think Jayant was a far more rational grandson or an inheritor to Charan Singh's legacy yesterday. What little I was.
You mean he had the sophistication to be embarrassed by the situation?
His father's indiscretion. But I think the smile which bordered on a smirk on the face of Mr. Ajit Singh yesterday made me lose all respect for the man.
So Ajit Singh has fallen in your estimation, even if he succeeds in blackmailing the government into creating a memorial for his dad?
Mr. Modi and the government will fall in my esteem irreparably if this happens.
Let me draw your attention to Bhupinder Singh Hooda, the Congress Chief Minister of Haryana, who's written in support of Ajit Singh's demand.
I'm not surprised. These are the kinds of people which give the noble clan of Jats a bad name. They try to blackmail, bully, bluster. The average Jat is a very nice, fair, honest, plain-speaking kisan. But this is Mr. Hooda.
Muskraiye, sir. Aapki tarif ki ja rahi hai. Muskraiye.
Main pure jaton ki tarif kar raha hu. But I have a problem. I have a problem with a political leader who, for elections coming, electoral gains, suddenly decide. He says, "Oh, even Mulayam Singh's son also says, 'Ye to anuyayi the un sabke.' I mean, it would be news to me that Chaudhary Charan Singh subscribed to socialist faith.
Tell me this." If Bhupinder Singh Hooda is simply being opportunistic, simply playing Jat politics and supporting Ajit Singh's demand, how do you account for the fact that the Congress party has refused point blank to send anyone to participate in this discussion? When we rang them, Their simple answer was, this is an issue that's got nothing to do with us.
Two fold answers to that, Karan. A, not all Congress party, even in Haryana, is united with Mr. Huda. So that's number one. There was an equally big Kisan leader, which Haryana has of its own, which is in the fray in the Haryana, Chaudhary Devilal, and his fourth generation contesting elections. So I'm afraid, even...
And he has an even bigger house that he once occupied on the president's estate, which also could become a memorial.
No, sooner rather than later, we shall hear about that also. So I don't think that...
So Delhi is heading towards becoming a graveyard of the dead. Politicians that should be best forgotten will be now memorialized...
It should become a graveyard for the living out-of-power politicians.
Yudhvir Singh, mujhe ye batayega, how long do you propose to continue this fight? Will it continue forever till you succeed? Or, when no one is noticing, will you quietly give it up and disappear?
Basically, ये मैंने बता दिया कि ये 1987 में ये तय हुआ था हमारा जब टिकैत साहब ने आंदोलन किया चौल साहब के दाह संस्कार के लिए दो बातें तय हुई थी
1987 से लेके अब तक 40 साल और ज्यादा बीत गए
हाँ बिल्कुल तो बीत गए हैं और ये अजीत
बीच में तो आप खामोश रहे
अजीत
आवाज तो आपकी आज ही सुनाई दे रही है
अजीत सिंह वहां रहने आए थे माता गायत्री देवी के साथ एमपी नहीं थे उस टाइम माता जी रहती थी चौल साहब की मृत्यु के बाद और लोगों को यही था कि ये चौ साहब की स्मृति है और चौ साहब के बेटे हैं इसलिए रह रहे हैं और ये तो अब ये अखबारों के माध्यम
तो
से
आपकी लड़ाई जारी रहेगी
अंत तक जारी रहेगी
अंत तक किसके अंत तक जीत तक या आपके और मेरे अंत तक
दिल्ली के अंत तक भारत के जनतंत्र के अंत तक कानून के राज
के टू बी कंसिस्टेंट Shouldn't you in fact scrap all memorials for all politicians and revert Delhi to what is meant to be a city for the living rather than a memory for the dead who are often best forgotten?
You're absolutely right, and I totally stand by the statement that you make. I mean, in fact, the government bungalows are meant for government purposes and they should not be used in the way many people are proposing. And imagine if all these government bungalows were to be converted into memorials. Where do our ministers, our member of parliaments and officials stay? In hotels and in government,
in guest houses? Preferably, let them stay at their own expense. Why should we, the voters of India, pay for them or the taxpayers?
That is the question. Those bungalows are meant for official accommodation. If we convert them into memorials, then where do these people stay?
Okay. I think, Karan, the time has come to have a drastic change in the law of inheritance. Instead of the property passing from father to son, it should pass reverse post-mortem, son to father, this one. I remember also a small line from John Lacar, where it says, when somebody else's money passed through his hands, the definition of private property changed. That is what applies to government bungalows in Delhi.
Let me ask you about Deen Murthy House in particular. It was first designed as the Commander-in-Chief's house in the days of the British Raj. When Field Marshal Auchinleck left and General Karyapa decided he didn't want to live there, it became the Prime Minister's house. And it was ideally suited to be the home of the Prime Minister of the largest democracy in the world. Sadly, after Nehru died, it became a museum and a memorial. Shouldn't Deen Murthy House revert to being the official residence of the Prime Minister and house the Nehru Memorial anywhere you want? But why in Deen Murthy House?
Unfortunately, in the years since, we have developed it into a center of learning and security threats being what it is, the investment which has gone into this racecourse road complex is different. But I would say number 10 Janpath should revert, which is not only Sonia Gandhi and Rahul.
It's Shastri as well.
It's Lal Bahadur Shastri ji next door with families residing there. I think Mr. Yudhvir Singh has a very good point. Just because Meera Kumar was a speaker and Babu Jagjivan Ram got a memorial, those should be reconsidered.
My last question. संक्षेप में मुझे जवाब दीजिएगा इफ ऑल पॉलिटिकल मेमोरियल्स वर टू बी स्क्रैप सारे के सारे
जी
वुड यू देन बी हैप्पी एंड ड्रॉप योर डिमांड
बेसिक बिल्कुल ठीक कह रहे हैं अगर कोई ऐसा है अगर या तो मेमोरियल अगर रहेंगे दिल्ली में तो चौधरी चरण सिंह का भी मेमोरियल वहीं रहेगा
अगर कोई ना हो तो आप स्वीकार कर लेंगे ओके देयर वी हैव अ सॉल्यूशन टू द मैटर संबित आई होप यू आर लिसनिंग एंड होप बियॉन्ड यू योर गवर्नमेंट इज लिसनिंग एंड मे बी इवन द प्राइम मिनिस्टर Chaudhary Charan Singh supporters will drop their demand if you scrap all memorials and you at least personally, maybe even speaking as official spokesman of your party, agreed with that suggestion when I put it to you. So you have a solution if you want it, but you have to grit your teeth to implement it. Have you got the strength to do that? My thanks to all three of my guests for joining me and if you haven't, thanks for watching. Have a terrific weekend. See you on Monday.